ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free.
Thank you. As you can see for yourself, the earth is not spinning at all. Now, as you can see here, at an altitude of 121,000 feet, the sun and the moon are directly across from each other, just as you observe down on land. And as you can see, the horizon is at eye level, and it is straight, flat as a pancake, no curvature. If the earth were a ball, the earth would be in between the sun and the moon. You would not be able to see them both at the same time at this altitude.
I want you to notice how that little spot of the earth underneath the sun, see how it looks? Now pay attention to that, because it looks like that the whole time, which proves that the earth hasn't spun anywhere. Check it out. It's the same little spot the whole time. Now it takes this balloon about 3.5 to 4 hours to reach this altitude, so I time-lapsed it into 10 minutes. So for about an hour and a half, that sun has been over the same spot of the earth, proving that it hasn't spun anywhere. At 1,000 miles an hour, that spot should be long gone.
Now way over there where you see that moon at right now, that's the dark side of the earth. The reason you can't see it is because the sun is not going across the top of it to illuminate it. And most people ask me, you know, if the earth is flat, then why does the sun light up the whole earth? Well, it would if it were 93 million miles out in space, but it's not. It's very local and it's very small, which it can only light up half of the earth at a time. Now when it moves back around over to where that moon is, it'll light that side of the earth up. And it'll be dark from where we're viewing right now.
Everyone, thanks for watching. Have a good night. And God bless.
And ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free.